Space Exploration Technologies, or SpaceX, has already flown their single-engine rocket, the Falcon 1, successfully twice. Now it's time to move on to bigger and badder things. The rocket with 8 additional Merlin engines and aptly named Falcon 9. One of the biggest changes between the Falcon 1 and Falcon 9, besides the engines of course, is the use of Florida's Cape Canaveral as a launching location. Space Launch Complex 40, or SLC-40, was the old home of one of America's largest rockets, the Titan IV. SLC-40's first launch was a Titan IIIC rocket in 1965. The launch complex continued to deliver Titan rockets into space until the Air Force shut it down in April of 2005. Then in early 2007, the Air Force decided to lease the historic launching facility to SpaceX. Spring of 2008 is when renovations started on the SLC-40, including demolition of old mobile service structure, adding new liquid oxygen and kerosene tanks, as well as the construction of a rocket and payload preparation hangar. The first Falcon 9 rocket arrived at SLC-40 late last year, and we're now only a couple of months away from having the inaugural Falcon 9 launch vehicle on the pad and ready to fly. The first launch date is a bit fluid right now, depending on NASA's schedule, the weather, and how well the vehicle appears to be working. But SpaceX does expect to launch between 1 and 3 months after they integrate the Falcon 9 at the tower. For more information and to continue the conversation, visit spacevidcast.com. Join us live this Friday at 2 a.m. Coordinated Universal Time to chat with Apollo ECOM Cy Liebergott, who was on console when the famous words, "Houston, we've had a problem," were spoken. Remember to convert to your local time zone or check the website for additional details.
And temperature. Okay. Stand by, they got a problem.